Tuna going for it. Doesn't get there. Michael Messing hanging on. The Tuna goes down the outside. And quite a battle going on. Where we see Thermal.
We can see that for the national racing we use the more traditional British four stars, four riders as well of course. And the pair down the bank, down, look across the Tiger Tom Wilson, the man who also made it to the European semi-final last year. In trouble is Sean Pettit for the the battle is still on for that second place because Chris Tritton is putting the pressure on as well. Chris Tritton and Duncan Howard's back. Jenner then riding superbly as he came off that bend. Tucked in behind him, 32, Anthony Hansford. So then, looking for anybody's first place here is the struggle goes on. Tuna staying back a little bit, easing the clutch. Arndt Poland circling rounds. Looks like they're all going to come in line in a moment or two. So then, Arndt Poland being waved in because really we've number one Roy Martinson decides he's not quite in the right place, so he moves over and lets Arndt Poland come in. So then, Roy Martinson and Arndt Poland, the two Norwegians, side by side. Closest to us, number 10, Christian Inato from France. Just inside him, Aki de Graaf from Holland. They're away, and any moment now we'll see the gate go, and there we go. And up this side, Christian Inato making a fast start, but on the inside, it's Svinovind. And the Czech making a superstar, but right around the outside of a lot of them, we've got a tremendous lead here, as we see now. It's back in second place, Christian. Christian Inato is still there, in fact, staying ahead of Heike de Graaf. So, Christian Inato, I thought it slipped back for second. Rode a tremendous bend over there. We've got a fallen rider, and in fact, Heike de Graaf is tucked in behind him. And in third place, Zanek Snyderven. So then, first three, two riders having dropped out, but the first three motoring on. Great. Hockey de Graaf got awful close to the fence then. Third place, Zanek Snyderven, with an unhappy sounding engine, I'd say. Meanwhile. Second place, Hockey de Graaf. Third place, number three for Czechoslovakia, Zanek Snyderven. Rob, who's made it to two European finals. Number 13, right on the outside, Mikhail Messing. And coming in the middle there, Gerard Koch for Holland. They're in line, the starting team are happy. They're away, and Rob Price going well on the outside, but it's number two flashing through. It's Sebastian Rotzer making another good start, but Mikhail Messing goes around the outside and heads down the back straight. So then, number two, Sebastian Rotzer, and number 16, tearing the visor off, Stefan Lynn. So then, and the riders you will notice going for the final. Being pressed hard, number 16 being pressed hard by Charlie Reitman. Yet another helmet colour disappears. Number 13 heads into his last lap. Oh, Mikhail Messing is still there. Rob Price is still behind in second place. There's a good battle going on for third place. Who's going to have that third place as they come towards us? The moment, who's got the hit? Still number 16 head and number 5 with Charlie Reitman back behind the commander. And then as the Czech flag is ready. Number 13 it is, Michael Messing who wins. Second place. Ah, who's going to get the best of this first place? Oh, it's a tremendous battle going on. Very, very wide. Charlie Reisner looking for it. Reisner gets there just ahead of Stefan Lynn. And behind him, number two, the Bill Davis powered machine. It's a line. Right on the outside here, Peter Reed looking for better luck this time. And Jean-Claude Offray. Along, he's one in just inside of Peter Reed, and we're all running. I think they can be called into line. Jean-Claude Offray spins the back wheel a bit. In they come. So then, the referee is the tense. They're under starters all this. They're ready to go, and they're away. Martin van der Voort making a good start, but he's out on the slick, and it's Peter Reed right around the outside from John Boston. So it's Peter Reed and John Boston back in front of an international race. But, John Boston still there in second place. In third place is Mike Beaumont. Behind him, number 6, Alain Blondie. And I think the red lights will probably go on. The red lights are on. The rerun. So then, we're here in line once again. Peter Reed closest to us. I thought Offray inside him, and then Mike Beaumont, then John Boston, the number 6, Alain Blondie. And Blondie up the inside, and it's Alain Blondie with the advantage of that dry run into the first bend, but it's Peter Reed going hard after him, and then John Boston. Peter Reed comes through from Alain Blondie, and John Boston comes through to second place. Alain Blondie, now back to number 6, Alain Blondie to outride the two British riders. In fact, it's second, third and fourth places. Peter Reed and John Boston looks to be in trouble. Beaumont goes by and Mike Beaumont gets to third. John Boston now back to fourth. second place, Mike Bowen in third, John Boston in fourth, and in fifth place as they come past us very, very close indeed, number 14, Jean-Claude Auffray, the other Frenchman, and looks as though he may be going to have to pull out. The veteran Yorkshireman now lives in the Midland of Droitwich, up in the second place. And Blondie looked over his shoulder then as though he had a problem. Heads for the finish. Alain Blondie then goes for the second win of the afternoon. Alain Blondie wins. Mike Bowen in second place. Peter Reid in third. John Boston in fourth. Keeps it going. From Will James, from in third place, Alan Farman. Andy Riley has decided that he's not going to get any outings in the international, so he's having a ride in the national one. A fallen rider, he's perfectly okay, he's got back on it, hoping to get it running. Behind him, it's Paul Fry from Hereford, and then at number 187, Tony Eyre. Tricky looking at the name and then looking to the right for the number. Somehow we expect to have the number on the left. Nice clean start on the far side. The battle for second place with number 87, Richard Jenner, who had such a good outing early on. To close up on the second place, Tim Fay with a beautiful ride up the inside. Tim Fay up in the second. Tom Wilson. Quite incredible to see the mud being thrown up on it. Richard Jenner is going to side him. Sebastian Roetzer, who scored 5 points. Peter Reid coming to the line, number 7, has scored 3 points. Number 18, Mike Beaumont, has 8 points so far. And number 15, Art Borland, has yet to score. So then, they come to the line. Coming in Now we're in line, says the referee. The starting team move back. And away. And it's Mike Beaumont down the inside and Sebastian Rotzer looking for a good run around the outside. Doesn't get there. In fact, has to give way to Peter Reid because it's Peter Reid getting up into second place. So it's Mike Beaumont from Peter Reid. Showing us how it's done. It's Mike Bowman from Sebastian Rotzer because Peter Reid's in trouble, up into third place because Arne Fulen in need of points. But Peter Reid seems to have got it back on song again. Lost a place, has got it going again, but in trouble. Looks though Gerard Koch has got a problem. Sebastian Rotzer at the moment in third place, number 15 Arne Fulen, and then Peter Reid, and then number one Roy Martinson. So we're looking across to the far side. Mike Beaumont, Sebastian Rotzer. In the third place as they come towards it. It's still number 15 Arne Fulen holding off Peter Reid and a battle developing for the fifth place. Meanwhile then, we look across the far side. Still the who's going to get the best of the battle for third place? Quite a struggle though. Peter Reid then gets in just ahead of Arne Fulen to take third place. Closest to us, Martin van der Voorn right on the outside here. The referee is 10th, they are in line. The gate goes their way. John Bosting goes down through the middle, but first in the bend was Charlie Reitsma, number 5. And the veteran Dutchman going well, but John Boston emerges from the pack. Building up a big lead, and the battle goes on to second place. Coming through to second place, Aclav Matuna looking for that second place. He gets the second place, so the check comes through into second place. We have a fallen. Too sure where he's due to go, but the starting team have no doubts at all about where he should be going. And away, Rob Price up the inside, Blondley in second place, and right there with him goes number 3, Zenek Snyderwind. So the check of the back in determines the notch up some points. Snyderwind, I think, the challenging as we look across the two. Rob Price in front, and well, all sorts of things happening to number 8 then. Anki de Graaf nearly did a wall of death job around the boards, but he stayed on, he's still there, and he's still racing once more. In fact, he's challenging. Rob Price to lead. number 8 and number 3. The next Snyder wins, and Hunky de Graaf hard at it. De Graaf coming wide again, losing time, looking for it. Look at de Graaf go down the back straight. Hunky de Graaf really pouring into second place. He goes down, inevitable I suspect, because he was going so fast and round the outside. My word, what a ride. So then we look across to the far side. One time. Kitchen coming very, very wide, but maybe he'll get the drive off the bend and take the fourth place back. He does. There's Rob Cameron from Will James from Andy Riley and Andy. Kitchen in trouble, pulls off down in front of us. Meanwhile, the battle is still on. Andy Riley comes up the inside, and Andy Riley is there. Third place is Will James, in fourth place is Russell Foote, and in fifth place, number 2, Laurie Bloomfield, just ahead of number 38, Chris Underhill.
I'll run through the runners because I think they're going to be away before I could possibly complete it. John Blake, Paul Smith and Steve Smith, we think they're both non-starters. Darren Phillips, Will Palmer, Paul Fry, Miles Evans has been going so well, Tony Eary, Sean Pithock, Peter, no Peter Roy, Jonathan Dewey, and Ian Scopes.
Everybody reluctant to come into line. They're waiting for the rest of them to get in there first. It's Rob Price now coming in. They're in line. Now then, who's going to have the advantage here? The revs are rising, the gate will fly back, and it is done, and it's a clean start, and Beaumont gates well, but down the inside. So it's Beaumont around the outside initially, it was Matuna who led, but Beaumont is there, and it's Mike Beaumont going like a train out in front of the opposition here. Charlie Reitzner and Christian Ianotto, and Charlie Reitzner knows exactly what's going on. He was doing enough to go through to that semi. A fine racing frame there. So that's fine. Charlie Reitzner and in third place, it's number 10, Christian Ianotto, but Heikki de Graaf is doing it again. It's Heikki de Graaf round the outside of the... And he's through to third place again. Just look at this man, number 8, Heikki de Graaf. Second place, and Heikki de Graaf in third, and behind him, number 10, Christian Ianotto. But there he goes again, number 8, round the board, Heikki de Graaf. Well, we're up here, it's like an express train running around the outside there. Charlie Reisman in second place, Heikki de Graaf in third, Christian Ianotto in fourth, and behind him, Rob Price, and then number 17. Starting team, woo! It's away! And it's Boston down the inside, just ahead of Alain Blondie, but Alain Blondie hangs on in there, so it's John Boston, and Blondie gets caught up in amongst the hassle just there. And, and number 13 coming through there, Michael Messing, and it's all changed around on that first lap. Tremendous order. The number 13, Michael Messing, and number 7, Peter Reid. And Blondie, I think, in trouble. Seems to pull out wide. Behind him, then number 13, Mikhail Messing, another former finalist, keeping up the pressure, and a good battle for third place as Peter Reid tries to close out. Third place, I think, just Peter Reid. Blondie should be in red. John Boston should be in blue. Well, the reds are rising, and who's going to get the best of the go away? And John Boston catches the starting gate. The starting gate is caught around. Have we got a red light? We've got a red light. Red flags. Red flags. We have a red light. Into line then, and we've got Mike Beaumont, John Boston, then number 2, Sebastian Rosa, then number 6, they're away, and Beaumont makes a start and goes for it, Rosa goes with him, it's Sebastian Rosa for Mike Beaumont, but the pressure is on, and Beaumont goes very, very wide, Mike Beaumont desperately looking. Who leads? It's Mike Beaumont in second place, Alan Blondie in third, and Blondie moves through to take second place, and Beaumont slides a little wide, it's Boston back and forth, and Beaumont comes through to take second again from Alan Blondie. From Mike Beaumont, from Alan Blondie, from John Boston, and coming through, Charlie Weissman making up ground, looking to close up. So down the back straight they go, and next time around the last lap. From Mike Beaumont, from John Boston, from number six Alan Blondie, and from number five Charlie Weissman. So then, down the back straight they go. Half a lap to go. Sebastian Roadster wins. Mike Beaumont in second place. In third place, John Boston. Sebastian Roadster then wins the final. Mike Beaumont in second place. The full official result in a moment or two. But give them a cheer and a wave as they come round. But don't forget the fellow who finished second.
Checking the results, Mr. Kittleson. And as soon as he has confirmed or corrected the results, depending on what, if anything is necessary.
We have then the overall results of the 1988 first round of the European Grass Track Championship. The winner, number 18, Mike Beaumont. In second place, number 11, John Boston. In third place, number two, Sebastian Roadster. In fourth place, number five, Charlie Reitzman. In fifth place, number 10, Christian Iannotto. In sixth place, Alain Blondie. They're joined by number 9, Rob Price. Number 13, Michael Messing. Number 8, Mikey DeGraaf. And the reserve to go through, number 7, Peter Reed. We have a little more room. In third place, from West Germany, he came here last year, left as a reserve. This year he goes through well and truly to the semi-final, Sebastian Roadster. Number 11, he's going for that final again, it's John Boston. So John goes through with Sebastian to Lariol, and the guy who must have got a tremendous amount of pleasure out of this afternoon's performance, the rest of us did. Let's have Mike Beaumont. Don't lose that one, Mike. Fellas. When they're going to play the national anthem, I hope they'll tip us off. Mike, what are you going to say with yourself? You've got a real big grin on your face there.
Not a lot, really. I'm really pleased. Really, really pleased. A lot of people could me being selected again, but I think I warranted this selection today.
Looks a little bit like it, Mike. Well done, fella. Well done. John, we're going to have the national anthem, aren't we? Hang on, fellas. We'll have a few words with the rest of you. Let's have a word with the other two. John, you must be pleased. You had your moments today.
Yeah, I was just intending Okay. Keep Bill Davis happy then.
Oh yeah, yeah. The wet legs are really going.
Especially
El Mark
one. Well done, John Boston. Sebastian, nice to see you again. We wish you continued success. You enjoyed your day with us?
Oh, it was a nice game here. I hope many people understand a little bit German. That I speak many German words. Das war hier ein tolles Rennen. Die Bahn war wirklich nicht schlecht. Bis auf den zweiten Heat, da war zu viel Wasser drauf. Aber sonst muss ich dem MSC Tonbridge ein Kompliment machen für diese tolle Grasbahn.
are National Racing, and will be any moment now. And we got Faye, Chris Underhill, the boat, Adrian Mower, Neil Scopes, and Jonathan Duke, all going in race 19. And you can see there on the line over there.
Back in sixth place, we've got a rider down there, he's perfectly okay, just overslid. Another one lays it down, I think really in avoiding action as much as anything. Riders trying the outside line now, and Neil Scopes is trying, and it gets all the driver goes straight past him, Faye. Almost rushes him aside. Bottom bend. Still obviously very slick with all that power going out of the back wheel. Roger Mazur and Dave Harris. Tim Bennett losing second place, number 25, Peter Watts. And Mike Cameron in fourth. Peter Watkins and Roy Jones. My camera and Paul Randall.
Well, in fact, I say cheers because, of course, they're balloted for and they are actually in the programme. So Mike Baxter going for the same position as Mike Cameron, right on the inside of the track. Ken Lane on five, and looks as though we could be missing an outfit there. Five outfits, they break, head towards us. Ken Lane going well. Number 46, Russell Ling. Oh, it's Ken Lane. Ken Lane, Paul Uritz on the outside, seeking for the grip. And Russell Ling came right up the inside. And the flags go flying. In third place, they pass us. Ian Arnold just ahead of number 99. But Russell Ling and
Chris Skipper trying to come up the inside.
Who's got the third place advantage at the moment? It's 99 ahead of 22, so Peter Kirk's coming in.
And then Ken Lane goes us on his way, staying ahead of Russell Ng. Second place. Who's going to get third? And he hangs on in there. Number 22, Ian Arles, just ahead. So in this one, Bob Wilson, John Hiscock going in place of John Halsey, Dennis Shaw, Dave Manning, Kerry Phillips, and Lee Carpenter. Now then, we're away. And Dave Manning. Once again, we see a range of different lines up here. Dave Manning and Peter Blank coming wide. And Dennis Shaw losing a bit of ground. And in fact, it's number 52. It's Terry Phillips coming through. And Terry Phillips comes right through and takes the lead. Flicking sideways. I'm not quite sure where they're going because an outfit in there way down there. And we have red flags on both. They're away. Dave Manning making a good start. Dennis Shaw goes with him. This time in third place it's Nick Baxter. Now let's see what happens this time. Again. Are we going to see the pegs fly? No, not this time around. So it's still Dennis Shaw in second place and Terry Phillips in third now. Terry Phillips got quicker and quicker as the race. Terry Phillips and Peter Blank are down and the red flags go up straight away. Well, we are having a... inside as Rob Cameron gracefully lays it down, perfectly okay, just laid it down. What a nice corner from Andy Riley, but he loses it along the straight and Russell Brooks gets it back. Bloomfield, and number three behind him, Chris Tritt. So then, what a good race. down that straight. Andy Riley gets his nose in front of him. Interesting situation. Who's going to come off the bench in first place? Well, it's Dave Manning. And he didn't take a peg out, did he? But one or two others did. So Dave Manning away on his own. And back to so then, Dave Manning still in front of Rob Wilson. Third place man as they come towards us, Lee Carpenter, number 56. Challenges on, Manning on the inside, on the outside is Rob Wilson, and closing up on him, but right on the bend, but not able to do it down the straight. They're away. Dave Manning making a good start. Ken Lane trying to go with him. And looks away, just in behind him, number 25, it's Peter Watkins. So then, Ken Lane. Hugs the inside band, so does Ken Lane, there's no way through there. Still in third place is Peter Watkins, and tucked in behind him in number 66. Around the bend, hugging the edge of the bend now. I think the track has dried out a little. Third place man having trouble, so into third comes Stuart Anderson, number 66. Grab the man that comes towards us. Ken Lane tucked in behind him in second place. And third place as they come towards it, still number 66, Stuart Anderson, and behind him. Races and they're looking to those big finals. Meanwhile then, third place, up for six car. They're away. Rustling, making a good start, and Roger Meeser is heading going into the top bend, but it's Roger who gets to the apex of the bend first, but Rustling is heavily on the meter. Off this bend. Roger Meeser with it well tucked in, and indeed coming through, it's Rob Wilson comes through. Rob Wilson takes second and comes through ahead of Rustling. So,
camera. Roger me, Dave Harris. The Honda V4 singing away, still in second place is Rob Wilson, then Russell Ng, and in fourth place number 22, Ian Arm, and then number 55. Towards us once again, it's still Roger Meza in the lead, from Rob Wilson in second place, from Russell Ng, from Ian Arm, and then number 55, Gerry Adams, not enjoying that. Meanwhile, there's a challenge on here, Rob Wilson going for the line, and Roger Meza just from Rob Wilson, from Russell Ng. Oh, some very angry sounding multi-cylinders down there. The gate goes back and somebody else in trouble. Right, Mick Baxter the lead, Sam. Mick Baxter, who took the lead from number 52. Number 99, Peter Colvin. Here, and Mike Baxter having a little bit of excitement all his own as we look up there, and Terry Phillips has closed on him considerably, and Mike Baxter had a problem on that. Peter Colvin. They're away. Towards us, they come forward this line. It will change in second place, chasing the leader just ahead of him. And it's Alan Farmer who got a very good start, and we're looking across to the far side, and already the fellows are very good. First band ahead of Roger Meza, he does not quite sideways, so it's big time. There's a marker page on that top there. Right, it's Roger Meza, Dave Harris from Ken Lane, and Paul Yerrigan, and tucked in behind, it's number 52, Terry Phillips. Those markers, only a few centimetres in it. Third place is Terry Phillips. to achieve. Riding well.
Takes the flag, Ken Lane in second place. Terry Phillips looks as though he's going to make it for first. Superbly holding off Dave Manning. In third place is Nick Baxter, and in fourth place, number 55, Jerry Adams. Well, just as I said, the dust wasn't too bad. It started to fly in all directions, but it serves me right. So it's still rustling then, leading as they go into the last lap. Dave Manning, second place. Mick Baxter behind him. And Chris Skipper really working well as a team. And they win ahead of Dave Manning and Peter Blank. And then Mick Baxter. They're away. Making a good start there. Peter Watkins. Well, this will be an interesting corner, won't it, Jan? You know, and up through the middle comes Sanford 22, Gosiano gets back in front again, and it's an all-action sidecar race. Still there is Cameron in second place. In third place, number 24, Rob Wilson. On the inside and holds the advantage. Ian Arm is still there. And Cameron tries to switch lines and go for the inside, and he does on the top end. So Mike Cameron is in front. He'll have to go back to second place. Daz Phillips making a beautiful inside move there, getting ahead of Duncan Tollers. Going on his way from now, Daz Phillips in second place, Duncan Tollers in third. And he's running over 6 laps, so we must assume it's a big problem. Thank you.
he's done good tolerance. No change, and
come into line then. They're away.
My car, B final, and a nice clean start. Straight up through the middle. It's Gerry Adams who made a tremendous start there. And he very wide goes Gerry Adams, and up through the middle comes Mick Baxter. So it's Mick Baxter, Mick Gerry Adams, and into a place we walk in. Mick Baxter, still there as they come round once again. Number 55 is Gerry Adams in the place. Terry Phillips looking for third place. Terry Phillips has taken third place. Momentarily lost his third place, got it back again. Meanwhile, it's still Mick Baxter from Gerry Adams. And collision on the corner there, including the marshal. Still Gerry Adams chasing him. Now in third place, number 22. The end of the sixth lap. Still it's Mick Baxter who leads from Gerry Adams. And a long way back now to third place. Circulating. And they come again for the checkered flag. Mick Baxter it is who wins. Gerry Adams in second place. So as he's completed two-thirds of race distance. And the A solo finals underway before we can look up. Looks like Tim Fay, the man. Tim Fay in second place. Rob Cameron and Dandy Riley very close together. Tom Wilson just behind Paul Pratt looking to try and come through. Tom Wilson does, through to fifth place. Paul Pratt in sixth. Just to Paul Pratt, and then number 9 comes by. So Russell Foot getting up into contention. Then Rob Cameron and Tom Wilson. Tom Wilson has had a good day, looking to close right up. Had to throw it sideways a little there to knock the speed off. Just when he was making a big effort to try and take the place ahead of him, it's perfectly okay. Will James.
sitting a few metres adrift, Andy Riley watching the action.
Okay there, so what could be one of the most exciting races of the day on the line?
No way, we have a clean start and Ken Lane has got away.
Roger Meade looking for the inside lane, but not this time because the inside lane is Ken Lane, isn't it? So it's Ken Lane up the inside. Roger Meza right there with him, and it's Russell Ng. They're going to press on Russell Ng, battling away. So then, Russell Ng looking to... second place, and they're gonna have to hang on to those very tight inside lines. And Russell Ng coming around the outside, and Mark Wilson actually in third, Russell Ng in fourth, and we've probably got a tight car race. Roger Meza, the master of the inside line, will hang on to it. It's Roger Meza from Ken Lane, and Ken Lane go hard after this. Russell Ng in third, Rob Wilson in fourth. In fifth place is Mike Cameron. But Ken Lane not giving up. Gain a few lengths, they close up again, and look at Russell Ng. Russell Ng coming round the outside, but still Roger Meza from Ken Lane, from Russell Ng, from Mike Cameron, from Dave Manning. Still goes on, and it's still Roger Meza from Ken Lane, from Russell Ng. Roger Meza still there, Ken Lane still there in second place. Russell Ng in third, Mike Cameron now fourth. Nothing stuff going round the outside of Ken Lane. Roger Meza in front, Ken Lane in second place. Russell Ng has the silver third. Mike Cameron in fifth place. It's a, I think, what a good sidecar race to end the day.